Hello everyone, in this video we have one circle, one semicircle, and then here this length is given 8 and these two lengths are given 2 units, and these are tangent point, and here is the center of the yellow circle, and then the length of the red line is asked. Okay, first step, if we connect these two corners, notice that this angle is opposite of the diameter, right? Therefore, here must be equal 90 degrees. And then, this side, I'm going to represent with M. For this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, we get the value of M, right? So, M squared plus 2 squared equal 8 squared. So, M squared equal 64 minus 4, therefore M squared equals 60, M equal root 60, right? Okay, let's write here, M equal root 60, and then let's draw a perpendicular like this. And let's call here theta. This angle must be equal theta, right? And then here, I'm going to represent with alpha. Notice that alpha plus theta equal 90 degrees. That means here must be equal alpha. Therefore, this triangle and this triangle are similar, right? Because they have same angles. Okay. And then notice that ratio of the similarity between these two triangles are equal 2 over 8, right? So 1 over 4. That means if there is an x unit here, this length must be equal 4x. Right? Okay. And then, if we connect these two corners like this, this angle is, notice that, opposite of the diameter, right? So here must be equal 90 degrees. Therefore, these two blue lines must be parallel, right? So if here is alpha, that means here must be equal alpha. So this triangle and this triangle are similar, right? Therefore, if there's a 4x opposite of the x, opposite of the 2 must be equal 8 unit, right? Because of similarity. Okay. And then if we connect these two points, we get a bisector line, right? Why? Let's remind you, if you have a circle and let's draw two tangent line like this, 1, 2, and let's call here center of the circle. And then if you connect these two points, this red line is always angle bisector line. And then I want to represent the diameter of the semicircle with capital R like this. So if we apply angle bisector theorem, therefore ratio of these two sides, 8 over 4x, must be equal ratio of these two sides, capital R over 8, right? So let's simplify. That means capital R equal 16 over x. Let's write here 16 over x. And then if you focus on the biggest triangle, for this triangle, we can apply Pythagorean theorem, right? Let's clear here. So root 60 whole squared plus this side 10 plus 4x whole squared equal 16 over x whole squared, right? So root 60 whole squared equals 60. If you notice that x must be equal 1 unit, right? Let's try it. If you want, 60 plus 196 equal 16 whole squared. So 256 equal 256. That means x equal 1 unit, right? So let's call here r for this triangle. If we apply Pythagorean theorem, therefore x squared plus r squared equal 4x whole squared. So r squared equal 16x squared minus x squared. So r squared equals 15x squared. R equal x times root 15. So we know that x equal 1. That means r equal root 15. Right? And then notice that this length equal 8. Right? Therefore, the length of the red line must be equal 8 minus radius, right? So we know that radius equals root 15. That means the length of the red line must be equal 8 minus root 15. Okay, you found value of x by trying, right? But if you don't want to try, then a long road awaits for you. Now let's find all the roots of the equation. 60 plus 100 plus 80x plus 16x squared equal 256 over x squared. If we organize the equation, so 16x squared plus 80x plus 160 equal 256 over x squared. So if you multiply by 1 over 16 both sides of the equation, therefore we get x squared plus 5x plus 10 equal 16 over x squared, right? Okay. Therefore, x to the power of 4 plus 5x cubed plus 10x squared minus 16 equals 0, right? Okay. How we can factorize this equation? Let's clear here. If you separate minus 16 as minus 1, minus 5 and minus 10, like this, plus 5x cubed minus 5 plus 10x squared minus 10 equals 0. These two equations are the same, right? We only separate minus 16 as minus 1, minus 5 and minus 10. Then it can be written as x squared minus 1 times x squared plus 1 instead of x to the power of 4 minus 1, right? And then if you take into 5 parentheses, these two terms, likewise, let's take into 10 parentheses the last two terms, equals 0. Therefore, it can be written as x minus 1 times x plus 1 instead of x squared minus 1 times x squared plus 1 plus 5 times. We know that the expansion of x cubed minus 1 equal x minus 1 times x squared plus x plus y, right? Plus 10 times, we know that the expansion of x squared minus 1 equal x minus 1 times x plus y equal 0, right? Okay, and then notice that these are common factor. So if you put into x minus 1 parenthesis, x plus 1 times x squared plus 1 plus 5 times x squared plus x plus 1 plus 10 times x plus 1 equals 0. Right? Okay. So x minus 1 times, if we distribute x cubed plus x plus x squared plus 1 plus 5x squared plus 5x plus 5 plus 10x plus 10 equals 0. Therefore, x minus 1 times in parentheses x cubed plus x squared 5x squared plus 6x squared and 5x, 10x and x plus 16x and 1, 10 and 5 plus 16 equals 0. Right? That means x minus 1 equals 0, so x equals 1. This is the first root of this equation. Right? So we know that this equation have four roots, right? x1, x2, x3, and x4. Okay. We found first root as 1, right? x1 equal 1. And this equation, if we equalize 0 again, so x cubed plus 6x squared plus 8x plus 8x plus 16 equals 0. It can be written as 8x plus 8x instead of 16x, right? And then if you put into x parentheses, x times x squared plus 6x plus 8 plus 8 times x plus 2 equals 0. 8 equals 4 times 2, so the expression turns out to be x times x plus 2 times x plus 4 plus 8 times x plus 2 equals 0. These are common factor. If we put into x plus 2 parentheses, x plus 2 times in parentheses x times x plus 4 plus 8 equals 0, right? That means x plus 2 times x squared plus 4x plus 8 equals 0, right? Okay. And then let's clear here. That means x plus 2 equals 0, so x2 equals minus 2, right? And then x squared plus 4x plus 8 equals 0. So if you convert this expression to a perfect square, therefore x plus 2 whole squared minus 4 plus 8 equals 0. So x plus 2 whole squared equal minus 4. Let's square root both of the equation. We have two scenarios, right? First scenario, x plus 2 equal root minus 4. And second scenarios, x plus 2 equal minus root minus 4. Let's calculate first one, x equal, can be written as root 4 times root minus 1 minus 2 equal 2i minus 2. And second one, x equal minus root 4 times root minus 1 minus 2 equal minus 2i minus 2. Okay. This is the third root, and this one is the last root. Notice that this three roots is smaller than 0. So, as you can see, the equation has only one positive root. Therefore, x equal 1, and the red line, which is asked, equal 8 minus root 15. Thanks for watching. And if you want more videos like this, please subscribe my channel. Bye.